Subscribe to my channel, Aspiring Kings and Queens, aka Cynthia MP. And this is Cyrem Joy Segador.
Yeah, or you can call me Joy for short. Go check out my channels too. I do a lot of travel videos, but I also do a bit of a vlog.
You love her channel, trust me. Her Snapchat will come up here.
Hey.
My Snapchat will come up here.
Follow me on Instagram as well.
Oh yeah, down below. All her social networks will be here. All my social networks will be at the end of this video. And what we are reacting to today is, what if your airplane door bursts open mid-flight? I am just hoping this is a prank, because I don't want to even think of that ever happening, or like the chances of it happening, do you know what I mean?
I know. Well, personally, you ride on planes a lot too, right? Like, that is my worst nightmare.
Oh my god. I will pee myself. I'll do it. I'll be like, God, take the wheel. Jesus, take the wheel. Like,
honestly.
Like, I'm done.
Honestly.
Nah. Yeah. Alright, we're gonna go on and play.
Ready?
Yeah.
Plane trying to relax.
Terrible thought crosses your mind. What would happen if that airplane door opened? Commercial airplanes pressurize their cabins to match the atmospheric pressure of 8,000 to 10,000 feet above sea level, even though the cruising altitude of the plane you're in is 30,000 to 45,000 feet in the air. As altitude increases, atmospheric pressure decreases. This is due to Earth's gravitational pull on the air molecules in the atmosphere. The closer to the Earth's surface, the stronger the force exerted on these molecules. If the door were opened, the plane would depressurize in less than 0.5 seconds. Unless your seatbelt is fastened, you and any loose objects would immediately be ejected due to the difference in pressure. During such a scenario, survival
rates are very slim. You're safe if you have your seatbelt on.
Because the air is substantially thinner,
so you'll die anyway.
There is substantially less oxygen. A gradual decompression in the cabin will cause the oxygen mask to drop from above, and on average, you have 18 seconds to put the mask on before hypoxia kicks in. Hypoxia occurs when oxygen levels decrease, causing symptoms of nausea, dizziness, and unconsciousness, leading to death. The oxygen reserves on the plane would last for only 10 minutes, enough for the pilot to descend rapidly to 8,000 to 10,000 feet to match both the internal and external pressures and give you hope for survival. Freaked out yet? Don't worry. The chances of the door opening are so small because there's 8 to 10 pounds of pressure exerted on every square inch of the plane.
Exactly. It's not like a bolt.
Airbus A380 as an example, the main door measures 4,288 square inches, meaning 38,590 pounds of force would be required to even compare, this would be equivalent of you trying to move 3 African bush elephants, the largest land mammals on Earth. Additionally, plane doors are almost always electronically locked by the pilot through functions accessible only
from inside the cockpit. Yeah, but what if he didn't lock it, huh?
And to ease your worries more, it would also be nearly impossible for someone to punch and break through an airplane window. These windows can also be made with up to 6 layers of various types of strong polymers and bulletproof.
Okay, I'm safe.
Furthermore, these windows are almost always rounded to decrease drag while in flight, thereby preventing cracks.
Comment if you saw that video.
Peel off a glass layer.
In a car that drove it off.
That's probably the plastic. It was brand new.
Compared to one.
Maybe that was the inside, but it wasn't
for air travel related accidents. So fasten your seatbelts. Pay attention to your safety videos, and above all, enjoy the flight. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure you subscribe because we make new science videos every Thursday. And click the bell because we're here.
When they're like, we're now about to take off, they're gonna, like, all the air hostess get in the middle. I'm like, if and then. I've heard this plenty of times. Like, but the first day when I flew on a flight, I was so vigilant. I was so, my eyes are like this, like any movement, I'm like, anyone walking down, I'm like, yo, don't make any sudden movements. I will jump on you. I wouldn't land safely.
To be honest, on planes, I actually enjoy turbulence.
If you're like one out of a fucking million.
It kind of rocks me to sleep, to be honest. There was one point, this was on a flight from Korea back to Paris, and basically it was just super like this. I was sleeping, and I woke up because someone screamed, and I woke up and it was like
legit,
like this,
like you drop
it. Yeah. Oh my and I was just like, yo. You know what? That you know, whenever that happens, I'm just like, you know what, Lord. I've done whatever I had to do on this earth.
It's time for me to come home.
From our sins, I'm ready. And then the Lord decides to keep me alive. So he has more plans for me.
Like when we were coming back for Christmas here to Spain, oh my gosh, there was like, I don't know, it was just random, it was turbulence. Like, and I was thinking, has the flights always been like this? And I was scared because I was thinking, look, thank God, I thank you because you let me survive Christmas at least. Like,
was that like that we were in?
Yeah!
Oh yeah, and Balin was shook. Balin was like, this ain't normal. I'm like, don't say that.
That's what made it worse. Like, guys, so we were all three of us. There's another guy, Balin, shout out to you if you're watching this.
Hey.
He was just making it worse. He's like, guys,
this ain't normal.
This ain't normal. It shouldn't be like this. Oh my days, guys. It shouldn't be like this.
The thing is, it was a clear day.
Yeah.
That's why we were like,
why is it like this?
Yeah.
And we're like, we were still ascending up into the sky.
And I was like, yo, this is just thick air.
It was weird. Literally. Yeah, I think it was the clouds that it was like penetrating.
I don't know what was going on, but something going on with the air and the clouds.
Literally. Like, alright. So that is our video of what if your plane goes burst open mid-flight. So if that ever happens, guys, you're safe, you're in safe hands, you know. The plane will just break into little pieces. Hope you're in that piece and you're good. Seatbelt on while it's flying down. You're still there. They told me to keep my seatbelt on. She said, coming off till I land. Who's landing it?
That's great. That's great advice.
See the pilot just on his half, of the plane, like he's a bit confused. He's probably shouting from the others, keep your seatbelt on
until we land. Oh my days. That is never happening.
That is never happening. Alright guys, oh man. We love you guys so much. If we've ever never said that, love you guys. Show some love to us as well by liking, commenting on both our channels. And you know, to all my kings and queens out there, stay loyal as I know you guys will. And to all my snakes, get out my
way. Hey,